Sit a while and play, friend.
This looks like the crashed pig cart. Tracks show they run into the forest. There they are. Mount and whistle and hope they trust me. I wonder how the farmer trained the pigs to follow a whistle. There's one pig returned. I'm still not clear why he can do this.
Survey the area, Sunan.
It's raiding season and I'm shepherding pigs through the mud. Maybe Dag was right.
Show me.
Come on, pig. It's like you don't want to be offered up to the gods. It's an honor, I assure you.
Two fat piggies playing in the mud. That should be all of them. Aim for the pig herder.
Here you are. All your runaway pigs back in one piece.
Thank you. These boots are new and I couldn't bear the thought of them covered in mud. Oh, I have your promised tokens, but I think you've also earned the right to choose which god will receive the offering.
Ah, Novid, I see you have brought back your shop.
Oh, yes. And have I found some treasures for you?
Show me what you have.
Have a look.
How can I earn tokens?
Ah, simple. Try the festival activities or help around the settlement.
I must take my leave. So long.
See you soon, Eivor.
Hera, you've outdone yourself with this bonfire.
It is my design, but many hens help to gather the wood.
The guards will favor us when they see the smoke and all the offerings we have collected for them.
Speaking of offerings, everyone has gathered their sacrifices and left them for collection at the shrines near the waterfall.
Are you about to ask me to act as collector?
Eivor, you're our leader. Everyone looks to you to set the example both in war and in celebration. Also, you are very strong and have a knack for carrying things.
So my true value is as a pack horse.
Would a pack horse be entrusted with choosing which god receives our offerings? Go and see what people have left at the shrines. Choose only the offering that you think is best and return here. I have news from Frankia. The plunder there is of such finery that Norse have ravaged the land up to the very gates of Paris.
I've heard of this city. I should like to see it someday.
Can I interest you in a game of Orlok?
asked about this land, my friend. Go, Sunan. See you, old friend.
Nice day today.
Another Okar came after.
Let's get out of here. Can't raise the sail yet.
Sing, my ravens.
Dark is the shadow.
Let the sail out!
Mercious men are called to strive.
You Southskulls, got a story?
Have you heard me tell the tale of the six Christian missionaries I lured away from their faith into the worship of Almighty Thor?
You showed them how to turn the crosses into hammers, simply by flipping them over. They fainted with joy. That tale?
Yes. Yes, indeed.
We need an epic tale.
During my 19th winter, King Styrbjorn ordered the construction of a new longhouse. The splendid hall you now see at Thornburg. To build this longhouse, he employed the help of 20 men. I was among them, as was Fradi, the strongest and stoutest man I had ever seen. He set about felling trees and hewing wood for timber. Fradi was the fastest of us, dropping 41 trees in only 2 days. On the third day, a spindly man called Gnar was near upon felling his first tree. He had hacked it all the way around like some mad animal. When the tree fell, he did so in a direction he had not wished. Straight down upon Fradi. Gnar called out, but it was too late. Fradi had only enough time to turn and face the doom bearing down upon him. With that, he raised his arms to embrace the timber hammer. The force of the trees falling drove Fradi deep into the snowbank, yet his arms never let go. He held that angry trunk as a lover. Like hounds, we scooped at the snow to reach him. We found Fradi 10 feet down, alive but in pain, still bearing the tree upon his shoulder.
That's a song.
Monastery! Bound to...
Let's finish you!
Hold him tight!
Innomination!
fight smart. Use your limb.
Come, help me with this. Hey, come here a moment.
Can't do this alone.
Counter!
Aid me. Be my eyes.
On who gets the kill?
Run up the sail! Let's have a song. Let's hear a story.
Some time ago, I met a wandering skald in search of a jarl or king to serve. He had not composed a verse in years, and was fearful of losing his skill. I said I knew many such great men. A few jarls, a handful of kings by name. But to my knowledge, all of them had many skalds of their own. This poor skald was disappointed and thanked me for my time, asking my name as he departed. Dag Nithison, I told him. The skald's eyes went wide. Dag Nithison, he exclaimed. of Hornburg? I nodded and said, the very man I am. The poor skald sung to the skies with joy. You are a legend among legends, he said. Let me compose a verse for you, if I may. Imagine my surprise at hearing such praise. But I agreed. So he began for 2 days composing a most lovely verse on my behalf. Yes, a most lovely verse. Unforgettable, yes. And I will... yes, I will recite it for you one day. When we have time.
A story from my youth. This one has no lesson to be learned or message to be gleaned. Often my father liked to take me on hunts in the forested lands east of Arvaldsnes. I loved these solitary times with him. I had never felled a beast myself, and my father saw that this upset me. I was only a boy, but I had the dreams of being a man. So one winter, my father asked me to perform a bargaining ritual to the goddess Skadi to improve his bow skill and snow sight. With glee warming my heart, I caught a hare and sacrificed it to the goddess, asking in exchange of skill and sight for my father. When the ritual was done, my father and I set off into the forest. We hunted all day until night fell, and we slew no game. That night, around the fire, I was sullen. My sacrifice had not been heeded.
Save it! Hi, Eivor.
What do you see, Sunim? It looks as though people left messages to the gods. I wonder who wrote what. Continues to surprise me.
Did you read the notes that everyone left?
Yes. Some interesting prayers, to be sure. The offering has been made.
Lift your torch and commit our offerings to the god of your choice.
We offer this to you, Lady Freya. May you grant us many riches on our raids. May we find fortune and return safely.
You've done well, Eivor. You've represented our clan with humility and grace. I know that everyone appreciates all you do for us. You should check in front of people's homes. There might be tokens of thanks waiting for you.
Each festival seems to bring with it more revelers.
It would appear that Ravensthorpe is gaining a reputation for our celebrations.
Back for another verbal lashing?
I'll make you eat those words. My wits and wallet are fine the way they are.
You look well today, Eivor.
have to go. See you soon.
See you later, Eivor.
I'd like to see what you have in stock.
All right, if you're done.
I will see you later, friend.
So long.